Hello, this is Professor Zaman. Welcome to Hasan Zaman Educational Video Series. This video is in our DC circuit series. Let us continue our discussion on series parallel circuits. So first thing we'll deal with, what if these resistors are not equal? Let's redraw the circuit. This is again 2 ohm. Let's assume this is 3 ohm. And this is 6 ohm. What is the combined resistance or equivalent resistance if one resistance is 3 ohm, other resistance is 6 ohm? From our discussion on parallel circuits, the equivalent value of this resistor will be their product over sum. Product is 3 times 6, 18, and sum is 3 plus 6, 9. And 18 by 9 is 2. So that means the new circuit will be 2 ohm, 2 ohm, 12 volt. And if you combine these two, it will be 2 plus 2. 4 ohm. That means the current here would be 12 by 4, 3 ampere. And if you put back 3 ampere here, this voltage will be 3 times 2, 6 volt. Now the question is, what is the current through these two resistors? We can do it two ways. One way would be finding the voltage across them, then dividing the voltage by their resistor value. So let's do that way. So this is 6 volt, and so this will be 12 minus 6, also 6 volt. I have to say something, that is, we are actually applying KVL here, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law. This is 12 volt and this is dropping 6 volt, so this has to be 6 volt. Even though this is kind of premature because we haven't really learned KVL very systematically, but I think this is something you can understand. So this 6 volt will be both across this resistor and this resistor. So this current will be 6 by 6, 1 ampere. This current will be 6 by 3, 2 ampere. So we found the current using Ohm's law. Another way we could find these currents, suppose we don't know KVL, then we could not say this is 6 volt. Okay, let's say we don't know. Then we could say this current is coming here, 3 ampere. And this is being divided into two branches. And we can use here current divider rule, CDR. Let's call this I1. To find I1, you have to put the other resistor on the top, 6 ohm. And at the bottom, you have to put their sum, 3 ohm. 6 ohm times the total current 3 ampere. Important thing to observe here, this 2 ohm resistor is not coming into the picture. New learners make this mistake. They think this should be part of this equation. No. Because how this current will be divided is only determined by these two resistors. It has no bearing. Whatever the value of this, 3 ampere is going through it. And being divided here according to the ratio of these two resistors. So it will be 6 by 9 times 3, 2 ampere. So I1 is equal to 2 ampere. And I2 will be this 3 ampere minus 2 ampere, it will be 1 ampere. But if you want to find using current divider rule, so you have to write I2. When you are finding I2, you have to write the other resistor on the top, 3 ohm, and at the bottom you have to write both, sum of both, 3 ohm plus 6 ohm times the total current, 3 ampere, it will be 3 by 9 times 3, 1. So this will be 1 ampere. So we got the same solution using current divider rule. So now we will go to a little more complicated circuit gradually, so you get used to solving them. A little more complicated version of this circuit would be if we add another resistor here. So this is also 2 ohm. So from now on, we will probably not draw the minimized circuit if we can do it mentally without having to draw the new circuit, because you can, in most cases, you will be able to picture the modified circuit or reduced circuit, and you don't have to draw it in that case. So for this circuit, what is the total resistance? Like I said, you have to start from the furthest part of the voltage source. So these two are in parallel, so equivalent resistance is 1 ohm. You have to divide by 2 because they are in parallel. And this 2 ohm and this 1 ohm and this 2 ohm would be in series, total 5 ohm, so the current through this branch will be 12 by 5 ampere. So that will be probably 2.4 ampere. And that current, after coming here, will be equally divided. One part will go this way, the other half will go this way. And if you multiply the currents by the resistor values, you will find all the voltages across the resistors. That means you have solved the circuit. Okay, now let's look at a little different structure of this circuit. What do you think? Is this a new circuit or same circuit? This is same circuit as you probably have thought. Even though the structure looks a little different, but it's still current coming here will be divided into two branches and they have equal resistance values. So the current will be divided in half among these branches. So all the solutions remain the same because this is essentially the same circuit. Now what happens if we add one more resistor here? Now the circuit has changed. So I start on the right side. And what is the structure of these two? Are they in series or parallel? One good way to understand that is to find out how current will be flowing through them. You see, this current that will be coming here will flow through this resistor as well, the same current. So it doesn't matter if you draw this resistor here or here, they are in series because the same current is flowing through them. So this is a very important technique. So these two are series, so that means they are together 4 ohm. And what is the structure of these two with this two, with this 2 ohm? If we again look at the current path, current coming here, after coming here, it will be split into two parts. One part will go this way, other part will go this way, and they combine again and come back to the source. So because the current splits, they are in parallel. This 2 ohm and this 4 ohm. And what is the equivalent value or equivalent resistance of this 2 ohm and 4 ohm? we can use the product over sum formula. The product is 4 times 2, 8, and sum is 4 plus 2, 6. So 8 over 6 ohm. And that resistance is in series with these two. I'm not going to solve this. You can do it. Let's change this circuit a little more and let's find out if we can understand the new circuit. Let's assume this resistor is not here. What is the new structure? Again, if this resistor was here, it would have been easier to figure out that they are in parallel. Now we have moved it to here, it may confuse you a little bit. The current, after coming here, it will split along these two paths, two parallel paths. So they are in parallel. Doesn't matter if we draw it here or here or here, they are in parallel. Let's put back the resistor that we had here. And let's extend this circuit a little more. Let's make them 2 ohm as well. When we did not have these two resistors, we found out the total resistance value. That is, these two are in series and they were in parallel with this one, and the whole thing was in series with these two resistors. What has changed? The answer is nothing. Because if take a look, current after coming here, just like before, will be split into this branch and this path. Current will not go this way because there is no way to come back. So there will be no current in these resistors. From the current's point of view, the circuit is still like the previous circuit. Because currents don't go there and currents don't see those resistors. So circuit has not changed. So if you ever see that kind of resistors, you don't have to consider them. Now let's make it a little more interesting. So say we had those two resistors. Two ohm. And let's make this 4 ohm. Let's now connect them. The moment we connect them, now these two resistors will come into play. They will contribute to the total resistance now. Because after current coming here, it will split into this branch and the other part, the remainder will go this way. And after coming here, it will split again along this branch and this branch. So let's try to find out the total resistance of this circuit. We have to start from the furthest point of the circuit. That means we have to consider these two resistors. And what do you think? I think you have guessed correctly. They are in series because the same current is going through them. And this together is 4 ohm, and that is in parallel with this 4 ohm. Since they are same, the command value to the right side of this will be 4 and 4 parallel, 2 ohm. And that 2 ohm is in series with this 2 ohm, that's 4 ohm. And that 4 ohm is in parallel with this 2 ohm. So equal, the value will be now product over sum, 4 times 2 divided by 4 plus 2, that is 8 by 6, or 4 by 3, which is 1.33 ohm. And that 1.33 ohm is in series with this 2 ohm and this 2 ohm. So in total it will be 2 plus 2, 4 and 1.33, 5.33 ohm. Total resistance of the circuit. So this current will be 12 by 5.33 ohm. And the same current will go through this resistor. Also after traversing the whole thing, that current will come this way. So let's find out this current, because so this is 12 volt by this current will be 5.33 ohm. If this is I, this current will also be I. No current flows to the ground. This current goes and comes back to the battery. Reason of this ground is only to set the voltage at this node to 0 volt. And voltage here is 12 volt. It is not contributing to current at all. And this current then it will be split. After coming here, it will be split. Remember the total resistance to the right side was 4 ohm. So current through here will be double than the current through this part. Okay, because this 2 ohm is half of the 4 ohm. So current will be double here, current will be half of this current on the right side. And that current after coming here will split into two equal parts. Because this is 4 ohm, this is also 4 ohm. There are more things to discuss in this topic. I hope you will continue to watch our next videos. Thank you for watching. Bye.